Welcome back to the ElevenLabs Agents Academy. In the previous videos, you've learned how to set up your very first conversational agent and integrate it into your website or mobile application. Now, as you know, we're using LLMs as the brain for our agent. And we can choose between, you know, all the leading LLMs as well as provide our own custom LLM. However, these LLMs do not have access to real-time information. So we will need to give the LLM tools to look up information in real-time. So in our case, we have our store assistant agent that should be able to look up order information in our system. So here I have a simple e-commerce page and I want to get information about my order from the API. So here I set up a simple API route where the agent can call this API to extract some information about the order. So in order to set this up in our ElevenLabs agent, we can head here to the tool section and we have two different tools available. The webhook tool will be called on the server side. So on the ElevenLabs servers, there will be a call to our webhook to extract some information and inject that into the agent. The client tool will be called on the client side. So if we need to take some action on the client, for example, to, you know, change the color of the page, dim our screen's brightness, you know, whatever action that you can only take on the client side, that's where you would utilize a client tool in combination with the ElevenLabs agents SDKs. Now, in this scenario, we will call our server. And so this will be our order backend. Here, we can add a description, fetch order information. And what we can do is we can put in the URL here, and then we can also add in some dynamic variables that we want to inject. So for example, in this case, the order ID. So now we can control the response timeout here. So depending on how quickly your backend would return this information, we could lower this timeout here. And what we can do is we can also configure this disable interruptions. So if we want to not be able to interrupt the agent while this tool is running. The pre-tool speech configuration is if we want to force our agent to say that it will, you know, execute the tool and, you know, give some context to the customer, we can force that here. We can also configure some authentication options or add in some custom headers that we want to call here. In our case, it's a public API. That won't always be the case. Now you can see here the path parameters that we configured. So this is the order ID. And it'll be, you know, specific LLM prompt, or it could be a dynamic variable that we're, you know, fetching and kind of adding in on the client side. So for example, if we have a JWT on the client, we can sort of inject that as a dynamic variable. In this case, we will, you know, have the agent ask user for their order ID. And then it'll use that order ID for the lookup. Fantastic. We can also add some specific query parameters here if we need that, or configure dynamic variables. But for our case here, we'll just have the order ID, which can be a string, could be a number. Here in our case, it's a number. And then we can add that tool in. And there we go. We can see we have a tool ID, some stats here as well. And so now in the next step, we can also edit this as JSON if we wanted to. We can see here, the details here, or we can switch to the form. So for example, if we are managing our agent via the agent CLI, then, you know, we would get kind of this JSON schema here, and we could manage our tool kind of as code if we want to. Okay, great. So we have our tool set up. And so now if we go back to our store assistant agent, we can configure the tools for this agent and we can add our custom tool here. So now we can see we have our order backend tool set up here. And now we can head back to our agent. And in the tools section, we can add a custom tool. And here we can choose our order backend. And then we just need to save this. And so now finally, our agent can actually look up our order. So let's try this out.
Hi there, I can help you track your order or answer questions you might have.
Yeah, can you look up the status of my order, please?
I can certainly help with that. To look up your order, could you please provide the order number? Alternatively, I can use your email.
Yeah, my order number is just 1.
Okay, I found your order. The order number is ord-2024-001. It was placed on January 15th, and the current status is shipped. The tracking number is TRK12345678. Is there anything else I can help you with regarding this order?
Yeah, what items are in the order?
Certainly. The order includes 1 premium wireless headphones and 2 Bluetooth speakers. Anything else I can help you with?
And how much was the shipping cost again?
The shipping cost was $15. Is there anything else I can help you with?
That's it. Thanks so much.
You're welcome. Have a great day.
Now, once the conversation is finished, we can look at our conversation logs here. So in these conversation logs, we will see a summary of what happened here, status of order number 1, some tracking information, but we can also look at the entire transcription. And what you can see here is that, you know, after we provided kind of our order ID, we then did a tool lookup to the order backend. And you can see here, the parameters extracted were the order ID. The order ID was a path parameter. So here 1 was attached to our GET request. And you can see that then our backend returned our success true and the data. And so you can see here the order data that was returned back from the backend. So now this data is provided to the LLM. So it has kind of all the information about our order. And so as you can see now, as we ask more questions about this order, we don't need to refetch this information. We have it in the context window now of the LLM. And so we can then answer kind of all these questions about our order ID. In the next video, we'll look at adding some client tools to perform other actions for our users on the client side. Until then, thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.